another opportunity for you. And then last is event like this. So you could be a speaker or organizer or volunteer for an event like this. Then you can drive the event in your city. So in every city is volunteer driven activity. It's a volunteer driven activity in every city. So you would need more and more volunteers. So if you are interested, maybe in the last session we can discuss how you can contribute and how you can, how this platform can contribute to your professional career. So that's about DiscussAgile. Then one thing that, so how many of you are Scrum Masters or any Scrum certificates? Great. So that's the larger chunk of things. One of the things that Scrum Masters, people who have done the certification in Scrum, so CSM, CSPO, these are the entry level certificates of Scrum. And if you want to go ahead, if you want to become a Scrum coach or Scrum trainer, one of the roadblocks is that you need to gain 70 SEUs and become a CSP certified Scrum professional. So one of the objectives of this group is that through these webinars and other events, we constantly help you gain Scrum knowledge and Scrum education knowledge. So that you can become a CSP in near future, whenever you have 70 SEUs. So in last conference also, we promised people to deliver around 40 SEUs. So many people were able to avail that opportunity. I know around 10-15 people from Pune who finally become CSP because that they were sort of around 20 SEUs, so many that became lazy when they started raising 16 days, kind of gave up. So if these kind of activities keep happening on a regular basis in every city, it gives people an opportunity. So see, it's a Scrum Alliance user group, so any activity that you do under this group, any knowledge sharing event like this or any webinar will give you some benefit in terms of Scrum application units. So that's one area where this group can directly contribute to all Scrum Masters. Apart from that, Eisenbris, this is the company that I work with. We have a lot of programs, online programs called classroom trainings, which also offer you Scrum application. So before we get into the next level presentation, I wanted to briefly talk about the roadmap to CSP, just to give you an idea how to get there. I think 2-3 people are sitting in this room who already became CSP, they were part of the last conference. So it's called Certified Scrum Professional. The idea is that it tries to validate your Scrum experience. And one thing that really helps is that you constantly in touch with Scrum related activities. So many people who have done this basic certificate, then they don't really get into the practice. Or even if they get into practice, they have their own version of Scrum which is they apply in their own organization. So when you get into this kind of framework, which is not purely Scrum or Agile, but your own distorted version or your own version which is working for you, that you don't get an idea of what is working outside. So if you keep coming like to meet up like this, or if you keep working for your Scrum education units, then you also know that what is working outside. Right? So so these are Scrum Alliance bullet points. They say that you validate your practical experience by becoming a CSP, you demonstrate, and then you expand your career opportunities. So these are four things that according to Scrum Alliance you can achieve by becoming a CSP. So these are the three criteria that you need to be. At least one Scrum certificate should be there, valid. In good standing, then you should have at least 36 months of experience of Agile and Scrum. And all SEUs should be in past 3 years. So any Scrum education unit that you aren't beyond 3 years won't be counted here. These are different categories. So if you have any questions related to category, maybe we can have an open discussion. Briefly, category B is Scrum Alliance related coaching. CSM, CSP or CSD training would fall into this. And any Scrum user group or Scrum gathering or any event related to Scrum Alliance like this will fall in category A. Thus, we can discuss if you need more information about any category.
So what about the webinar? That be under category A or?
So webinar, there are two kinds of webinars. One is a Scrum Alliance user group webinar. Like if we have a webinar on DiscussAgile platform, it could be counted in category A. Any webinar that Eisenbrees does, or say BMC does a webinar which is on Agile, that will fall in category F. So you can still count a webinar which is not directly a Scrum Alliance user group activity, but it will come in category F. So even in category C, you can count a training which is like internal training in your organization which you did, you delivered or you attended. But only three, it should have three basic objectives. One is, it should have a defined agenda. And Scrum Alliance should be able to verify that agenda, that either it is available on a public domain and you can give a link that, yeah, this is where, this is the training that I attended and this was the agenda. So it should be related to Agile, it shouldn't be something else. Could be any event. You can attend a safe Agileist training, you can attend a Kanban training, but the URL of that training with the complete training objective should be available in a public domain so that you can give a URL and they can do a verification. That's the only criteria. Category D is if you become a volunteer for an event like this, or any Scrum gathering, you become a volunteer. Can get 15 SEUs in category. So that's about the category. This is simple, you can go to your Scrum Alliance dashboard and you'll be able to find areas where you need to enter the information. If you need more information, we can have an offline discussion about this. This is the cost of certification. Around $100 is what you need to pay to get your application renewed. And this is non-refundable, so in case your application gets rejected, you have to pay 100 again to get it again. But mostly they give you a review and feedback, they give you ample time to respond. If there are some conflict in some SEU categories, you'll get time to respond to that. But if you are not able to do in the second attempt, then maybe you lose $100. And then certification cost is around $150. Once your application is approved, that is the second phase. So you have to pay fees in two phases. First phase is $100 for review of application. And second phase is $150 for the certification cost. So this is Scrum Alliance dashboard. I don't think I need to explain to you. These are some of the programs that we have at, as an Eisenbridge. So one is CSP Fast Track, which is can help you become CSP in 3 to 4 weeks. We have online programs, so you can go back. We have programs in this category. D5. We are an REP with Scrum Alliance, and other programs are approved by Scrum Alliance to offer you category B SEUs. So if you avail those programs, you can complete, quickly finish all the category B programs and get the requirement of Scrum education units. Then if you attend SAFE as it is, or if you combine SAFE plus CSP, that is also a good opportunity. You get end up getting a Scaling Agile certificate as well as complete CSP. So that's briefly about the certificate. And maintaining, you need to renew it every 2 years. The cost of renewal is around $50. You need 40 Scrum education units. You need to earn 40 in order to renew it. And then elementary certificate. So if you're done, say, CSM and CSPU, and then you go for CSP, then only renew CSP. You don't need to renew CSM and CSPU. That will be automatically done. And I think CSM is every year. This is every 2 years. CSP opens the gate for all future Scrum Alliance certificates. So that's the prerequisite. So CSM is prerequisite to become CSP. I mean CSM, CSP. And CSP is prerequisite if you are trying to become a certified enterprise coach or certified Scrum trainer or certified Scrum coach. So anything like that, CSP is important. And one important thing that I would like to highlight here is it's not just CSP is important, it is also important that how old is your CSP. So after CSP, 1 year is minimum that you need to do some seva for Scrum Alliance before you can think of applying for the next certificate. So if you want to become a CSP certified Scrum trainer, I get a many training that I want to become a trainer. For that, CSP is important, that is one. And apart from CSP, you also have need to have the 1 year of core training with the existing CSP. Plus, you should be volunteering for events like Scrum Gathering, Global Scrum Gathering, and other Scrum related activities with Scrum Alliance. If you have any questions, we can quickly address it now, or we can have an offline discussion once we have the networking session on. It's up to you.
So for Scale Agile certification, do we need to have that minimum title of CSP or something like that?
No, no. So Scale Agile and CSP is not related to each other. Go back here. So Scale Agile would fall in this category. This is training outside Scrum Alliance, or any Agile training outside Scrum Alliance will fall in this category. So they are not related, it's not a Scrum Alliance certificate either, and it is not related to Scrum Alliance in any manner. But there is SAS, and that is the maximum limit for, though the training is for 16 hours, you get only 15. But you can club this with any other training. The benefit is that you have another reputed certificate with you. You get an extra knowledge of scaling Agile apart from the CSP certificate. So that's why I highlighted the CS SAFE program. Apart from that, it is not directly related. Fine? Any more questions that we need to discuss now?
PMI ACP will also come in SAFE.
PMI ACP, so if you do with Eisenbridge, it will fall in category B.
Okay.
If any other provider, if they have the REP relation with Scrum Alliance, it will come in category B. Otherwise, it will fall in different categories. So mostly, if it is a Agile related training, any training which is not related to Scrum Alliance in any manner, it will fall in category C. So in our case, our PMI ACP training is approved and agile as an Agile training by Scrum Alliance as well. So in a way you are getting two trainings. One is PMI ACP and one is Agile training on by Scrum Alliance.
So then after become a CSP, I can add those I want to take it. Like the training and pass has been done earlier. So once I'll be applying for the survey, I would around 86 SU.
Mm-hmm.
So if I apply for the SU and if I gain CSP, since I have to renew every 2 years, can I
so you won't be able to use what you have done in past.
Okay.
After you become CSP from that date, from in next 2 years, you need to earn 40 SCS. Right? So once you become CSP, then you can be regular customer of DiscussAgile. And we keep giving you SCS. Right?
Any less training will be happening?
Not planned right now, but we'll see definitely something can be done. Any more questions?